Assalamu alaikum, my dear respected brothers and sisters. My name is Sydul Haque. In our question and answer section, today's topic is Jummah Salah. If you have any questions, please send to info@alwomenmosque.org. What are the minimum number of participants required for Jummah prayer?
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakallahu khairan, Dr. Haque. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for hosting this program. Alhamdulillah, by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are able to discuss the contemporary issues that we are facing today. So alhamdulillah, this is a very common question in the Western world, especially the communities. There are not a lot of Muslim families living, and also in at our workplaces where we have Muslim employees working. However, they are not in big number, or they do not have any kind of break during the Jummah Salah, so they have to pray at work. And there are also some chaplain from prisons. They also asked this question to me several times. And because there are some prisons where the Muslim inmates are in low number, and they want to host their Jummah prayer as well. So, and also it happens during the time of pandemic. We have seen some masjid, they did all keep their prayer open, and for Jummah Salah, there were very little number of participants for the congregation. And then also when we see a new mosque open, or some community where new mosque open and they want to host the Jummah prayer, and as the community is small, the mosque is small, there are not a whole lot of Muslim families around there, so there are questions arise. What are the minimum number of participants we need to have to host the Jummah Salah? So by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are able to discuss by looking at different sources. However, we want to understand that if there are sources in Quran which explicitly mention, or if there are Sahih Hadith where we find the answer explicitly, then we do not need to look any other sources. But there are cases where there are no reference in Quran or Sahih Hadith related to some of the issues or topic. For those issues or questions, we look at the madhab, we look at the scholarly opinions and try to find the answers. So today, inshallah, we will look at Fiqh As-Sunnah, Volume 2, Salatul Jummah, or the Friday prayer source. So based on the book, there is no dispute among the scholars that a congregation is necessary condition for the validity of al-Jummah. In other words, we have to have congregation for the Jummah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah al-Jummah commanded us to establish Jummah prayer on Friday. So this is based on the hadith of Tariq bin Shihab, who reports that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, al-Jummah is an obligation or wajib upon every Muslim in the community. However, the scholars do differ on how many people are required for al-Jummah. There are the Fiqh As-Sunnah mentioned that there are 15 different opinions on these questions. 15, 1, 5, and they are mentioned by Ibn Hajar in Fatah al-Bari. The strongest opinion is that Salatul Jummah is valid if there are two or more people present, since the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said that two or more constitute a congregation or Jama'ah. So this is very important that the Sahih reporting from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the definition of Jama'ah is more than one, or two or more constitute a congregation. So based on that premise, the scholars comes to the conclusions that if there are two or more people, they can pray Salatul Jummah. Then also the book we are going through, the Fiqh of Worship, Ibn Udama's Umdat al-Fiqh, or Reliable Sources of Fiqh. Based on that book, we also see that he has mentioned some information related to the number of participants required for Jummah prayer. So based on the book, the popular position of the Hanabali school is 50, 50, not 40. So there is also another position in the Madhab, which is that this is chosen by Imam Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy on his soul, and Sheikh Ibn Uthamin, may Allah have mercy on his soul, said that the strongest opinion is that Salatul Jummah is valid if there are two or more people present. Since the fiqh of Sunnah, it is referring to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that two or more people constitute a congregation. So this is very clear by that hadith that we can call a jama'ah if there are two or more people present to pray in a congregation. However, Hanafi scholarly opinion is that there needs to be three, excluding the imam, to have Jummah prayer. But we have seen the Hanabali said it has to be 50, but we also know that other mazhab mentioned the number 40. So based on the 40 number, where do we get that 40 number? So it is reported that the first Friday prayer was performed at Medina by Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This has been reported by Fatah al-Bari in Kitabul Umm. Imam Shafi'i related that when the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam reached Medina, he performed it with 40 men. This is also related in Hakim related a report stating that one of the first Friday prayers in Medina was attended by 40 men. So that is the basis of the 40 men. So the people were there 40, so there were no additional question asked number of people required at that time. So we see that the number 40 by Imam Hanbali, number 40 from the Hadith, and then the Sahih Hadith of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioning that two or more people constitute a Jama'ah. They are all, the valid point. However, depending on the situation, depending on the location, depending on the other circumstances, majority of the scholar, they agree that if we have to establish Salatul Jummah at any specific place, if there are less than 40 people, then Alhamdulillah, based on Imam Hanafi, if there are at least three people, we can pray Salatul Jummah or establish Salatul Jummah at that place. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the ability, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to understand what are we researching, and most importantly, the acceptance of Salah is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah knows best for all the scholars whoever provided the opinion they said. So hopefully it makes sense, and it answers our questions that how many number of participants required for Jummah Salah. And as we are in a different kind of situation, you know, our situation can depend on the number of participants. However, there are no doubt for a Jama'ah to be called more than two people or two or more people by the Sahih Hadith of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So hope it makes sense, Dr. Haque.
Jazakallahu khairan, Dr. Rashid. We'll continue this program in the future.
Jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum assalam.